Hey guys. Okay, let's talk safety tips with oils. Obviously, Young Living products are plant-based, organic, grade A essential oils. They only come from non-pesticide fields. They are hand-picked. They are the real deal. So anything that I am talking about today is only pertaining to Young Living oils. I cannot speak to any other company, and certainly the ones that you can buy for cheap, if you know what I'm talking about. They are cheap for a reason. They have extra yuckies in there. Young Living is only the oil. So, but there are a few safety tips. If you have infants, then you're going to want to heavily dilute oils. And typically our ratio is for 0 to 1 is 1 to 2 drops in a tablespoon of coconut oil or any carrier oil. If you ever hear an oily person say carrier oil, all it is a fatty oil. So coconut oil, olive oil, almond oil. Young Living actually has a V6 oil, which is a carrier oil that you can buy. But if you don't have that accessible, just use what you have. I've even used vegetable oil sometimes because that's all I had on hand and I really needed to dilute something. So 1 to 2 drops in a tablespoon of coconut oil. After they're about a year, you could do 1 to 2 drops in a teaspoon, or if it's a gentle oil like lavender, you may not even have to dilute it. But if you ever put an oil on your skin or your child's skin and they say, oh, it's hot or it's tingly, it's not burning them. It's just the reaction that our skin does when something is entering through our pores. All you need to do is slather a little bit of coconut oil or whatever your carrier oil of choice is on that, and it will calm it right down. Funny story, when my youngest son was 1, he got into my oregano oil. And if you know anything about oregano oil, it is a hot oil. Okay, so when you put it on the skin, it's gonna feel hot to the touch. And he put it all over his face, and I just hear him screaming because it hurts, obviously, and his face is just beet red. And all I did was, first, stay calm. And second of all, I put just a slather of coconut oil on there, and within 5 seconds, he was totally fine. It's not gonna, Young Living oils are wonderful because they're not gonna hurt your kids. Okay, they're good for our body, but it may be a little hot in the beginning. So just kind of go easy. We never want to put oils in our eyes or down in our ears or any mucous membranes. You can put them around if you're having eye irritations. Just put it around the eyes on the eye bones. If you have pain in your ear, put it around the ear and certainly down the neck. We don't ever want to put it in mucous membranes. You can put Vitality oils in your mouth. That's totally fine, but eyes, ears, and any other place, let's just keep it out of there. You want to make sure that supplements and different just body care products are, you know, obviously not ingested by young kids. But if they are, no need to fret. Drink lots of water. One of the things I love about our cleaner, our Thieves household cleaner, is it's plant-based. So if I know a lot of children are super drawn to what's underneath the kitchen sink, and if they happen to get in that and get some in their mouth, even on the back of the bottle, it says just drink lots of water. I can't do that with Clorox and Windex. I have to call poison control and maybe go to the ER. I don't have to do that with Thieves. I mean, you certainly can if you want. But it's all plants, so just drink lots of water and they should be fine. Same goes for you. I don't really know of adults who drink cleaner, but hey, you know, you do you. Anyway, so if there's any other safety concerns that you have with Young Living essential oils, please let me know and I'm more than happy to answer those. Y'all have a great day.